I'm Soledad O'Brien. Welcome to Matter of Fact. Before the pandemic, nearly half of all rural hospitals in the United States were operating at a loss. In the past decade, 127 rural hospitals have closed their doors, and another 453 face the same fate. That's according to the National Rural Health Association. One reason is rural areas have higher populations of poor and aging patients, many with chronic health conditions. Another reason, hospitals had to cancel elective surgeries and other outpatient procedures, which accounted for most of their revenue.
The real challenge is, as COVID-19 continues to surge among rural communities across the U.S., if those rural hospitals are not able to get back to normal business as usual, we're going to see hundreds of rural hospitals close within the next year.
Our correspondent, Jessica Gomez, traveled to Titus County in the northeastern part of the state and spent the day at a rural hospital that's struggling to stay afloat.
Northeast Texas. Far from the hustle and bustle of big city life. But now, the usual peace and quiet here.
COVID-19.
Shattered by a pandemic.
As you know, we had another surge in COVID.
This is the morning huddle at Titus Regional Medical Center.
We have currently 7 RNs out with COVID. We all know that that stretches us thin.
So they call the COVID-19, and it just alerts everyone that they're moving a COVID patient.
Upstairs in the ICU, 28-year-old nurse Megan Barrett, preparing for yet another COVID patient.
They're worried, they're scared, so I just always try to make them feel at ease.
The only ICU within an hour's drive is busy. COVID cases are skyrocketing here.
She's running fever, she's short of breath.
CEO Terry Scoggin trying to keep his hospital afloat.
One of my biggest concerns and fears is under my helm or under my leadership, we will not make it.
The hospital, which serves 5 rural counties, was already struggling financially when COVID hit. Now there's community spread.
Just like that.
More than half of the patients at Titus Regional are on Medicare or Medicaid, and nearly a third of the population here is uninsured.
What it means is, from a rural perspective, it's hard to survive. As an independent hospital, there's no money coming in. There's not too many people on Wall Street or the East Coast who are investing in rural hospitals.
10% of the staff here furloughed or let go early on, in anticipation of the millions that would be lost in canceled outpatient and elective procedures. Federal stimulus help, not enough to cover the losses.
So what do you need from us?
Terry Scoggin blames himself.
I regret that we had to make the decision. I regret, more importantly, that I did not have us in a financial position where we could have weathered the storm.
A storm with no end in sight. As cases rise again, they're doing more here with less.
I'm gonna go up and then straight back.
Short on the testing they need, equipment and medication. Other Texas hospitals that helped in May are now maxed out themselves.
The staff are stretched and they're very tired and they're working a lot of overtime.
We built an intubation cover.
Respiratory therapist Lindsay Hutchings devising this homemade tent using a shower curtain to protect doctors when intubating patients. It works well, but she is exhausted.
The last few months have been mentally, physically, emotionally draining.
The hospital staff also falling victim to COVID-19. Since March, 30 employees have tested positive. One of them didn't make it.
We ended up opening the vessel.
Radiology tech Michael Sines grateful to be alive and back at work. The 35-year-old new dad on a ventilator with COVID-19 for a week and a half.
Just hoping I would get out of it and go back home. Because, yeah, I just had a 2-month-old and, yeah, now I need to get back to him.
COVID-19, all clear.
Fighting here for survival, not only for their patients, but for a community depending on them.
As the number 3, number 4 employer in the community and the type of jobs that we're able to provide, the economy would take a dramatic hit. We're gonna make it because we're gonna make it because we have to.
She looks good to me.
Megan Barrett making it through yet another shift. Last week, she clocked 67 hours, her toughest yet.
They're dying alone, you know, and it's hard. And you try to be in there with them, and they may not know you're in there, but just try to be in there and hold their hand. These people need us. They really do need us. I'm trying not to cry. So it's been hard.
In Titus County, Texas, for Matter of Fact, I'm Jessica Gomez.